Hi friends, welcome back to my channel and to another episode of Flute Life with Katie Flute. Today I have another flute review for you. I'm going to be playing a professional model flute by Altus. So before we get right on with the video, I want to first give a big thank you to the Flute Center of New York who has provided me with this flute today and who is sponsoring this video. So if you're not new around here, then you definitely already know about the Flute Center of New York and my love for that place. The Flute Center is a huge flute store located in New York City, but they also ship worldwide. If you're looking for a new flute, definitely check them out, and you can use my code KTFL to set up your own free 10-day trial. Basically, what happens is you tell the Flute Center which flutes you want to try, they will send them to you with free shipping. You can keep them for 10 days and play them. If you like anything and want to purchase anything, you will also get an 18-month warranty if you use my code. My code will also give you a 10% discount on sheet music. Okay, so now let's get started. Okay, so before we open the case and put the flute together, let's read a little bit about it first. So this is Altus Flute Model 1107 from the Altus Artist Series. It is handmade in Japan and has a Britannia silver hand-cut headjoint, Britannia silver body with silver-plated mechanism. So according to Altus, the Britannia silver helps the flute to obtain a really big, beautiful sound with darker coloring maybe than, you know, a flute made of sterling silver. So sterling silver is 92.5% silver, and the Britannia silver is actually 95.8% pure silver. So that's a bit of a difference there. The Altus 1107 also has drawn tone holes, French or open hole keys, pointed key arms, stainless steel springs, and B foot joint. If you go on the Flute Center's website, you can also see that there's an option to have this flute made with a inline G or an offset G. This particular one that I have here has an offset G key. There's also an option to add a C-sharp trill key and a split E mechanism, both of which this particular flute has. So the Altus 1107 actually has three different head joint styles, and I actually have four head joints here to show you with the flute today. So Altus offers three head joint styles, the classic cut, the Z cut, and the V cut, all of which I will try today. And each head joint style has its own characteristics. According to Altus, the classic cut head joint provides warmth with excellent projection. Its pure tonal center allows the artist great flexibility with an infinite color palette. The Z cut head joint has a more rectangular embouchure hole, which produces a quick response without sacrificing flexibility or control. The sound is open and free with a darker tonal color. The V cut is one of Altus's most powerful head joints, capable of producing an exceptional tonal depth without sacrificing flexibility. With a steep angled lip plate, this head joint performs at the cutting edge of modern head joint design. And then on top of these three options for the cut of the head joint, there is also an option to customize it further. The standard style is with a silver lip plate and riser, but other options include a silver lip plate with a 14 karat gold riser, or the fanciest option, a 14 karat gold lip plate with a 14 karat gold riser. For those of you who don't know, because honestly I did not know this until a few years ago when I had to look up this information for another video, the riser is the part of the flute that attaches the lip plate to the tubing of the head joint. When you blow into the head joint, this is the place where the air makes contact and it vibrates to produce a sound. So obviously different materials for the riser will have an effect on the sound. Okay, so now let's open up this flute. So we've got the standard French case with the case covering, and this one has this nice strap here that you can carry it on your shoulder if you want, which is nice. So the inside looks like this. There's this nice detail here where it has Altus in gold lettering on the inside. That's really nice. I haven't seen anything like that before. So I thought first I would try the head joint that just came default in the case. This is the Z cut head joint. And actually I tried in a previous video the Azumi by Altus flute, and it had the Z cut head joint, and I really liked it, so I'm excited to see how it feels now on this more professional model flute with all this solid Britannia silver, which is really cool.
Okay,
So first impression, it definitely has a really nice, rich, dark tone quality to it. And I think it's maybe a bit darker than my Miramatsu sounds, but I like it. And I'm still really liking this Z cut of the head joint. And I'm actually surprised because I was reading here that it says it's more rectangular. And in the past, I know I've tried some head joints with a rectangular cut and it wasn't really for me. So I don't know, I just find that interesting that now I kind of like this rectangular head joint cut. And so just like in the Izumi by Altus that I tried in that other video that I'm mentioning again, the mechanism is really light. The flute itself is not too heavy. It feels really comfortable in my hands and I like how the mechanism feels. So now let's try some of the other head joints, and I want to play them all back to back just so I can see which one I like best and you guys can listen and tell me which one you like best.
Thank you.
before I let you know which one of the four head joints was my favorite, please leave a comment down below right now and let me know which one you like the best. So I was really surprised at how all four of them felt so different, and I think they also sounded pretty different. I'm not sure how much comes across on my recording, but they definitely all felt very different from one another. So I like all four of them, but if I had to pick my least favorite, it would probably be the classic cut. To me, it just felt a little bit stuffy or closed sounding. I think at first I didn't think that as much, but then as I was playing the other ones, I was like, whoa, there's a lot more possibility and room for sound with some of the other ones. So I think that it's a very nice, delicate feeling sounding head joint, but I don't know if it's exactly the one that I would choose if I were to have to pick one of them for myself. But once again, if you're looking for a new flute or a new head joint, you need to try them yourself because everyone is different, everyone has a different preference, everyone's embouchure is different, so you have to try it in order to figure out which is right for you. Tied for second place, I think, would be the Z cut and the V cut head joints. I like both of them. The Z cut, I was saying before, I tried on the Izumi flute and I really liked it there, and I liked it here too. But I also was surprised that I really liked the V cut. It has a very like zany sound, maybe a little like edgy sounding, but I really liked it, and it has some sparkle for sure. But my favorite would have to be the one with the gold lip plate, the gold riser, and the V cut. Of course, I think I picked the most expensive one. I really liked this one. Maybe it's because I'm used to having the gold on my flute and I like how that sounds, so I thought that it was a nice combination to have the gold with the lip plate and the riser, especially mixed with the rest of the silver. This one is super responsive, and to me it just sounded a lot more vibrant and alive than the other ones. I'm not sure how well that came across in the recording or if you also agree with that, but I really liked this one. So thank you all so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this video. I know that I had so much fun getting to try these different cuts of head joints, and once again I was surprised at how different they all felt and how different they all were and sounded. And it's incredible that there's so many differences, and even the smallest tiny detail of the cut of the head joint can make such a big difference. So yeah, nerdy flute stuff. And once again, a big thank you to the Flute Center of New York for shipping these flutes to me and making this video possible. Be sure to check out the Flute Center's website and let me know which of the flutes that they have that you want me to try next. Also, if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any future videos from me, and go follow me over on Instagram @katieflute. Thanks again so much for watching, and I'll see you all in my next video.